source of many people reverting back to Islam. He is also a certified New York City family court counselor and has been able to successfully reconcile multiple issues of Muslim families over the years. He frequently receives many questions from around the world and has issued about 4,000 fatwas in the last 3 to 4 years. I hope and pray that Allah Azza wa Jal continues to bless him and his work of dawah, and may his voice reach every corner of the world. I have the honor and privilege to announce the founder and leader of International Channel Ahad TV and the Islamic Research Foundation of New York. I kindly request him to say a few words. Please welcome, we have between us our beloved scholar, Sheikh Omar Said. Jazakallah.
Hello. Everyone hear me? Yes. Everyone can hear me, right?
Yeah.
I know everybody's hungry, right? So inshallah, I won't be taking you too much time. Understand? I will be taking you very little time, so it won't be like a complete long speech. So just like a little, give me like 10 minutes, I will explain something, because this is not my place. Okay. Alhamdulillah. Wassalatu wassalamu ala rasulillah wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajmain. Amma ba'd. A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. Rabbi shrah li sadri wa yassir li amri wa ahlul 'uqdatam min lisani yafqahu qawli. I was reading a Surah Al-Baqarah, chapter 2, verse number 218. Allah says, innal ladhina amanu وَالَّذِينَ هَاجَرُوا وَجَاهَدُوا فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ أُولَٰئِكَ يَرْجُونَ رَحْمَةَ اللَّهِ وَاللَّهُ غَفُورُ رَحِيمٌ. When I was reading a tafsir, I get more details about that. In the first part, Allah says, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. So Allah is talking to those people who believe on the word of God. Now raise your hands, how many believe in the word of God? Raise your hands, come on, raise your hands, everybody raise your hands. Everyone believes in the word of God. So everyone believes whatever Allah says in the book of Allah. Is that correct?
Yes.
Everyone believes that. So we have an iman because we are Muslim. We know we make a mistake, we do sins. But we do believe what Allah says is 100% correct. In the next part, it has two parts. The first part it says, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. The second part, Allah says, وَالَّذِينَ هَاجَرُوا وَجَاهَدُوا فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ أُولَٰئِكَ يَرْجُونَ رَحْمَةَ اللَّهِ. Allah says, وَالَّذِينَ هَاجَرُوا وَجَاهَدُوا. Now I will divide this into two parts. وَالَّذِينَ هَاجَرُوا. Those people who travel for the sake of Allah with the pure sincerity. And another part, Allah says, وَالَّذِينَ هَاجَرُوا وَجَاهَدُوا فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ. The word, Allah used the word jihad here, which simply means to do something for the sake of Allah. Like you work hard, you do anything, that Allah pleased with that. We divide this into two parts. وَالَّذِينَ هَاجَرُوا وَجَاهَدُوا فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ. Now those people who travel for the sake of Allah, not for the business, not for the job, not for anything, but strictly with the sincerity for the sake of Allah. In this another part, Allah says, وَالَّذِينَ هَاجَرُوا وَجَاهَدُوا فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ أُولَٰئِكَ يَرْجُونَ رَحْمَةَ اللَّهِ. Now Allah is saying those people who do jihad, who work hard in the sake of Allah. Now the word in this part, I will divide this into two types of people. These are two types of people. There's a type of people, like we have Mufti Ismail, we have Imam Mahmud, and we have another scholar visited from Al-Qatar. Now these people, we are working hard for the sake of Allah. Now there's another community who has didn't give the Allah tawfiq to do something for the sake of Allah, but Allah gave them a financial power to do something. But the reward will be same. What the people teach in Quran to somebody, they get the same reward. Those people who are investing for the sake of Allah is the same reward. So those people who cannot go, who cannot do hijrah, for the sake of Allah. They can stay home, but they can't have a sincerity to do something for the sake of Allah. You understand? Let's say, when we die, what things Allah will accept from us? In the Sahih Hadith, the Prophet ﷺ said, there's three things which will be accepted. Number one, what is that? Who can tell me that? Whose parents passed away, and his children will make a continuous dua for his parents. What is the number two thing? You build something for the poor people. You build something for the poor people. Like you build them some water dam, or you give them a water, you give them a house, anything, as long as that stays there, like a masjid. As long as people coming, praying, the people who somebody who passed away, he will get a continuous reward for that. And those people who donated for the masjid, they get the part of the reward. It's not wasted. Because Allah says in the Quran, those people, the example of those people who spend something for the sake of Allah, it will be multiplied. In the first part, in the chapter 2, verse number 218, Allah says, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. So now we believe that whatever Allah says in the book, it's everything is correct. So when Allah says that even if you spend anything, it will be multiplied. So that means we do have an iman that if we do something, we go on a hijrah, or we spend the money, we do whatever we want to do, it's going to be, inshallah, it's going to be multiplied. Now in this part, now the hadith has three parts. The third part is that someone, the scholar who passed away, he leaves some knowledge in the dunya, and that knowledge, the people are taking advantage of that knowledge. In that particular situation, those people who is even donating in the schooling, like Mufti Ismail has a Noor Center, the people who help a Noor Center, so that means you get the part of the reward. You get the part of the continuing reward. Because of your help, the Noor Center is getting more donations, is getting more help, we get more students, so you get the part of the reward. The similarly, the TV is something that is same Sadiqa Jariya. Now how many people accept that whoever is watching TV at home, they're learning something, a knowledge, they get the part of reward. Everybody get that? Everybody's understanding what I'm saying? So a lot of people stop not to use the TV, but it's not the TV who's a shaitan. The shaitan is your mind. Your mind, even if you go to in Russia, your mind goes with you. Even if you're sitting in the middle of a bad company, if your mind is perfect in the iman, you will not do any sin. You will not do that. Because we believe on La ilaha illallah. Now how many people understand what does this La ilaha illallah means? That we believe there's no deity of worthy worship, there's no object, not anyone in the world, in the universe, we will not follow except one Allah. We believe Him, we know that on the Day of Judgment, we depend on Him. We do not depend on our hard work. We do not depend on anything. We rely on the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the TV is something that we have established. This is the first time in New York, and the first time in America, and first time in the world, with the three languages. In Bangla, Urdu, and English. The reason I have come to this conclusion to have three languages, because mashallah, we have millions of Bangladeshi community here. They need the help. Our children are going to the public schools. They are getting destroyed. Who will be responsible? I am responsible. I am responsible because my child is going to the public school, it's getting destroyed. I was walking down the street, I asked a beggar. I ask him, how much did you make in a day? Because I usually walk around into people, I ask them, how much did you make? He told me, I make $20 a day, $25 a day, $30 a day. And some of them said, I asked the woman, how much did you make? She said, maybe like $40, $50. If you multiply that into 1 month, that makes $500, $600 a month. Am I right or wrong? Do you think these people sitting, standing on the signal, they are not making a $10, $15, $20 a day? They are making that much money. But as we are sitting home, let's see what I am doing for the Allah. What I'm doing? A beggar standing on the signal, he's making a $20, $25 a day. And if you multiply by that, even the lowest who has a small job, you spend every day $3, $4. How many of you have a cup of coffee and the sandwiches in the morning time. Come on, raise your hands. Come on, guys. Don't be shy. Just raise your hands. See? Maybe many people have it, right? So we spend $3, at least $2, $3 every day. Am I right or wrong? You think that makes a month how much? Multiply by that, $60, $70 a month. Am I right? Do you understand that? What if you give the little part of that and make this sadaqah jariyah for yourself and for those people who are working hard? Now Allah gave people to go on the path of Allah. Now Allah gave the tawfiq of those people who are sitting at home. Allah did not give them a tawfiq to go outside. But Allah gave them a tawfiq to do something by sitting home to help those people who are going out. Am I right or wrong? You're right, right? So we started this channel. It's a commercial free. It's a pure channel. We do not have anything else except the pure La ilaha illallah. We do not have anything else there except Muhammad Rasulullah. When you say Muhammad Rasulullah, that's it. That's our kalma. No more than that. Our mission is to establish this TV in every home in New York, in America, and in the world. People will around the world will know what is going on in New York Muslim communities. They can hear your voice. You can come down here, take the mic, say something. Your voice will be down in the Bangladesh, in Pakistan, India, everywhere you have a relative. They can see you. They can hear your voice, what's going on in New York. You can get a support from there. So our mission is our children are getting destroyed. That's the main target of the TV. Our generations are getting destroyed going to the public school. Our little project will be to build up the high school in Jackson Heights and to remove every Muslim child from the public school. How many kids, because of you, your kids will go to hell, and on the day of judgment, they will hold your shoulder and put you to Jahannam. How many people understand the story from the Noah? They were honest people, they were good, pious people, start people worshipping them. You know, basically what I'm trying to tell you, Shaitan does not target directly to you. He will target the coming generations. If your child is going to school, what do you think they are learning? They are learning a pure Islamic food? They are getting a pure Islamic food? No. Even they're getting a cheese sandwich, that cheese is not even a halal. This is what happens. When you eat anything from outside which is not halal, it goes inside you. That changes your character automatically. It changes you automatically. Then you see your child, why your child is reacting like this. You will not know that. Why my child is reacting like that? Because that's the root cause is because your child is going to the public school, and regardless how much you try to save them, they are getting a food from there and their character is changing. So I'm not going to be taking you too much time here. This is what we have here. We have series free. We have a postcard. And we have a pens. I suppose you get a DVDs also, but I couldn't get it on time. So I want each Muslim to take this and take more to give to other people. And we need to get used to this. Because think about this, our children are watching public TVs. We have a recitation from our news center. We have a program from Madani Masjid. How many people taking advantage? The women cannot go to the masjid. So they're taking advantage by we are doing the programs, they are learning something. So inshallah, how many brothers are going to make a promise to help us? Because if I get advertisement from companies, right? I can survive, the TV can survive, but this is not our project. This organization, Islamic Research Foundation, is sending out hundreds of Qurans and Islamic materials to thousands of people across America. The prisons, non-Muslims are becoming Muslim because we gave them a Quran. If you put a charity, if you donate anything because of your funds, we are able to buy the material. We are able to put this into our dawah work. Because if you cannot do that, if I ask the brothers in the masjid, how many of in the masjid right now go on the street, talk to the non-Muslim to teach them what is pure Islam? How many? No, how many of you has a permanent job to go on the streets to put the dawah tables and deliver the... No one there. So that means you have to help somebody whose permanent job is to do this. So inshallah, how many brothers are going to promise to help us in this project?
Everybody.
Everyone. And also, Each month, try to put $5, $10, $15, $20, whatever you can donate for the sake of Allah. Because this money is going to be used for a new center, and it's going to be used for a Madni Masjid, and also this will be using for our Dawah project. Because think about this, because of your money, people are converting Islam. Because of your funds, you get the reward of that. Everybody get that? Even you donate $5 a month, fix it. You want to pay $5 a month, okay. Allah does not see how much you paid. Allah sees your sincerity, that you want to do something for Allah. You want to see something what Allah wants from you. He wants to see your sincerity. We do not go there to force the Muslims. So inshallah, everybody promise that? We have a table, we have a postcards, and we have a pens, we have a CDs. And please fill up the postcards and finish it up, inshallah. And may Allah bless all of you and make this sadaqah jariya all of you. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.